Welcome back, everyone. Time for some more Skyshine's Bedlam. So, we died last time, so let's start over, shall we? We still have not actually unlocked any of these, which is unfortunate. I suppose we have to, doesn't actually tell us how to unlock, huh? But we'll figure it out eventually. So we're just gonna start up normal game. Use our, little bit of power here we have to do the bio research and the engineering. I like to start off with those. So we've done this way, we've done this way, let's go right. Let's go this one here. Alright. So it trundles through the arteries, escorted by law regulators and flanked by an army of prominent now-beam broadcasters, projecting the vehicle's impressive image across the surrounding Galatron screens. Pedestrians cluster on catwalks to witness the unprecedented boldness of the Dozer's journey into the malevolent wasteland beyond the walls. And then we head out. Alright. First stop, death and destruction. Crew disembarks to inspect the debris, only to be surrounded by a group of sinister cyborgs. Alright. Well, let's just go with what they give us here. Stupid Blitz. I hate the Blitz. You know who else hated the Blitz?
Britain.
Britain hated the Blitz. Alright, let's see. Alright, he can't hit anybody from where he is, unless he moves up there. Yeah, let's do that. Alright, let's move this guy here and shoot. Let him mix around our attacks here a little bit. Alright, that guy's dead. Just gonna take a second to move this guy back and collect this stuff. Since we got a second. Power. And we'll blast him. There's a decent chance this guy's... Oh, no. He went after that guy. Oh, well. Well, that's unlucky. Well, that didn't go as well as I would have liked. That's okay. Alright, so... Point of interest. Let's ride. While exploring the area not far from the road, the crew discovers the remains of a building surrounded by the rusted husks of several ancient vehicles. A faded sign above the statue appears to say, Chemestos Burgers Vatgone Satisfaction. Alright, let's enter. Venture inside, the crew finds a lot of rubble but little value until they discover a hatch in the floor of the rear. Unsealing the hatch, hiss of air, the room below has been hermetically sealed all this time. The crew descends a large chamber, seems untouched by the decay above. Alright, we find some racks of containers. Synth sirloin never expires. Alright, found some meat. A lot of meat. Excellent. Let's set up another one of those. So that's good information. Their weapons get stronger as time goes on. That's why he killed him. I thought he only did 3 damage, and then he did 4. That's what happens. Got a makeshift shelter. Trigger of blue blood. Splatter of flesh actuators. Saw augmentation gone wrong. We saw that in the last episode. And we found some power cells. Cool. Alright, so we got another thing of power cells. Let's use it to do that. Alright. Forging ahead. Sudden tower of metallic debris begins to tap a landing on the Dozer, resounding crash. We're boarded by hostiles. All right, so we've got, these are our two guys from before who are not hurt. Let's use another, I'm gonna put another Deadeye and another, I guess a frontliner. Yeah, we'll go with that. Oh, I didn't know that. So the ones with the extra like thing on them are mystery resources, I guess. Oh, I did not know that guy was over there. He's got a 4, so let's move you up here and shoot. Hmm. 9. Alright, we have no ability to escape this guy, so let's just try and take him out as much as possible. Say we got a headshot, we might have gotten lucky. This guy does not have a shot. He steps back when he has a shot. Alright. Man, we're losing two people around. That is not an acceptable thing to have happen. We're gonna be out of people in a hurry if that we keep doing that. Oh, there's an elite. Gotta go try the elite.
King Viscera said you scuzzers would be a challenge. Ha! Cobra Mane is gonna pound you banoobs into the man masher. Time to make paste.
Alright. So, let's take a trencher and a frontliner. And you know what? I'm gonna take another trencher just to be sure. Oh, this is the only guy we got? Alright. 14, huh? This is not good.
Crude. Power.
Let's see where this guy goes. Oh man, that thing hits hard. I don't know how we're gonna survive this. Since he seems to be able to walk far enough, yep, to do that. Ugh, this is not gonna go well. Focus on him. Go to him. He's at 4. There we go. Hey, and then the guy's out a veteran too.
Mark of shame, Kivisra would put Crowbar Main's head off on his neck for the failure. If you take me in your machine, I'll pulverize Lurks. You tell me to. Gotta go.
Alright, yeah. Alright, he's on the team. That was a big price, though. Not that one. This one. What is he? Oh, he's a frontliner. Yeah, we have one trencher left. Oh, that's not good. All right. Only moves with 5 not toxic material. Dozer continues along the road. Okay. Oh, that's just it. Traders are always willing to haggle. Reports of illness among your passengers, the number of passengers are being in alarming conditions and rapidly covers their bodies in strange purple fungus. They are almost completely immobilized. Upon further investigation, you determine that a portion of the meat you have acquired is tainted. some kind of toxic material. They're highly contagious. I guess we'll try and quarantine them. Infected passengers isolate another section of Dozer and seal as best as possible. However, many of your passengers are agitated by such close proximity. They refuse to travel on board any further. Oh, we just lost. Lost 115 passengers. Okay. Another elite's behind us, huh? Should we give it a shot? Let's give it a shot. I'm a sucker for elites. I can't help it. Alright, we got this guy. Alright, we'll take Crowbar here. We'll take one of our Deadeyes. Take our elite, this guy. We'll take two gunslingers, I think. Yeah, we'll go with that. Alright, so he can't hit those guys from there. Hey, check that out. All right, so we'll move him up one here and attack this guy.
Power.
Oh, he died. I'm so bad at this. Really thought we could take that guy down. Oh well. Nope, can't get in range for anybody, huh? Excellent. Okay. That's not good. That is not good at all. Guy's got way more health than I thought he did. Sorry, guy. Oh. That didn't work out so well, did it? I don't know how to use trenchers or the frontliners. I just don't understand exactly what to do with them. I mean, I guess you let them come to you? Is that the plan? It's eerily quiet. We drive on. All right. What's it? Crew wanders, toxic sludge, looking for like some kind of bizarre lodge. A number of mutants are heading towards the structure. They seem alive. Let's attack the mutants. Alright, put you back. We'll take this guy. Now that we've got him, take our... Oh, he's already out there. Take one of these guys. I guess we'll take... Isn't that one of these guys? I don't know. Wish I had a better feel. I mean, it's still early. I've only done a few episodes of this, but I feel like I should have a better feel of what's up. Let's let these guys move forward a little bit. Oh, we have plenty of this. We should make our life easier. A little bit. Get them fighting each other. So move this guy forward one, he can take this guy out. There we go. Power. Excellent. So if I get one more kill with this guy, I think he levels up. I'm 90% sure that he levels up. See ya.
Meat.
All right, they're done attacking each other. Right, let's take him out. Yeah, there we go. That's what I wanted to see. So if he goes forward and attacks. All right, excellent. That one went well, didn't lose anybody. That thing of interest was kind of weird, huh? It didn't actually give us much, just a fight. All right, let's go move forward. We need more of this. Mangled remains of some type of satellite. Stop and investigate. Parts of the exterior have clearly been scavenged already. The core remains mostly intact. Engineers managed to extricate several primary components from the casing and reassemble them into a functional weapon. Some type of voltaic disruptor can fire powerful focused electrical blasts. Electric guillotine. All right. What is that? Electrostatic discharge of otherworldly intensity can jolt enemies into oblivion. That sounds fun. I like jolting enemies to oblivion. Crew ascends a rocky incline. It appears to be a large pile of moist meat and bone. Also seems the pieces of Murado armor mixing with the sound of... Well, let's explore. Oh, this is how we got the teleporter last time. So let's explore the area. Stepping into the platform on the ground. Porch the platform. Yep, that was the... Yes. This is the teleportation machine that we got. We got this in one of the other episodes. I like that. Excellent. Alright, so let's move forward. We're running... Actually, you know what we're gonna do is... increase meat efficiency a little bit. And I'm going to improve this as well. Alright. Bedlam is notorious for its unpredictable climates. You're entering a particularly mist of corrosive enzymes. The haze is unlikely to cause damage, but the crew might get hurt. Okay. We need crude. Like, seriously badly need crude. Stop and investigate. Truck faded load reads mojos. Judging from the scene, the vehicle must have struck a troglopod in the road. Vermin are splattered in the truck's grill and windshield. Try and deliver it. Inside the cab, the driver and the passenger have met a grisly fate. Special order for Jarton Cornlash of the Splinter Heights, deliver at all costs. Let's try and deliver it. Why not? Special meat package. Alright, we are going to go for broke here and head right here. We're going to be almost completely out of crude. Discover what appears to be the carcass of several Runkalo. A bloodied man is on the ground nearby. The Runkalo herder is mortally wounded beyond your help, but he manages final words. Viscera's Jenkin Marauders bushwhacked me and carved me up whole herd just for the grins. Don't let all the meat go to waste. Alright, we got a whole bunch of meat. What do we do now? We have not enough crude to get places. Let's find out what happens when you run out of meat, or crude, rather. Oh, S.
S-O-L.
Got a shit out of luck Russian roulette thing there, I guess. With no assistance, passengers became discontent and decided whether they'd take their chances in Bedlam. Alright, decimating the atomic bonds, they're getting the entire swift boost. However, as passengers are filing out of the dozer, uncertain future, and massive enzyme cyclone strikes without warning, the corrosive storm blasts into the unwary passenger and whips through the dozer, decimating the atomic bonds of all organic matter. Entire contingent of passengers and crew is swiftly reduced to gruesome cellular stew. In your final moments, you take solace knowing your catastrophic failure will at least leave wreckage. Alright. And we're done. Okay. Didn't do so well that time. I guess we lost the SOL roll. Alright. I'll see you guys next time.